Here's how I borrowed an Adidas bag from Staples. Trigger warning, there is a blade in this video. So they were held together by these tags. So what I did was cut the tags off from the cardboard inside, and then I put the cardboard on a shelf and left it there. I then rolled up the bag and then folded the bag in half and then put it in my purse and left.
So you guys seem to like my last borrowing haul, so I'm doing another one. This is how I do it. it. I stick this little tote bag on my arm under my jacket, and let's see what I got.
First off, I bought this brow pomade and this gum. It's like $9, and everything else is borrowed.
Got it all from CVS. It's pretty easy because their alarms are fake. My cellar water, these Kiss nails, these Kiss lashes, the CeraVe facial cleanser that everyone on TikTok talks about, Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer, this Essence makeup brush, this CoverGirl palette, concealer, liquid eyeliner. This is the biggest thing, this palette. And wow, these are kind of pretty.
And literally tons of lip products. I got liners, glosses, lipsticks. These are so easy.
Stay safe.
5, 6, 7, 8. Dance with me in my backyard, boy. Looking super fine in your corduroy. Drive me round the block. We can go in a loop and we'll turn the volume up. But you gotta learn the rules and shit. There's a lot, like never do heroin and never do meth. Never go to parties below sunset. Never drink anything below 10 grand. Never suck dick unless the money's in his hand. Never fuck she and don't do porn. Never wear.
Now you're calling me up on the phone, so you can have a little wine and a run. It's only because you're feeling alone.
Becomes a crime that the corporations make the regulations and hold no one accountable when everything goes wrong. Let the rich and famous get away. Every time a high-priced mouthpiece starts to talk, his client gets to walk. Tell me, where is the justice? If there's any justice.
Copywritten in all my decisions. This is not supposed to be a way of living. Turn my temple down into a prison.
Spending my life so long before I need to call you. You're the only one I want by my side when I fall asleep.
They're really easy to borrow. Just put it in if you have a big jacket. You literally can't see it at all, so if you want to borrow one and take it with you when you first walk in, grab it and then walk around for maybe like 3-4 minutes and then go buy a pack of gum. They'll just think you bought it somewhere else. If you're talking about borrowing alcohol bottles, those are better to borrow with a bag. However, the small ones are actually really easy to borrow. Since they're small, they can fit in pockets and then go into jacket pockets or in the back of little hoodies or with a jacket.
This, for example, is a little bottle. You could just take it and it fits in your sleeve and then it could go perfectly in a pocket.
Most bottles are actually flat enough so they can lay there and it won't cause a bump. You could also just grab a drink like this and walk in the store, drink it, and then throw it away in a bathroom. So...
knowing nothing in life, but I gotta get rich. You could check the throwback pics, I've been that bitch. I'm a hot girl, I do hot shit. I do spend this income on my outfit. I don't text quick, cause I ain't thirsty. These bitches mad, they wanna.
First, you need a huge ass bag. Find an empty aisle and just throw that shit in there while you're walking. No one is constantly checking the cameras anyways. Or crouch down, put your bag in between your legs and throw that shit in there. And never forget to check for sensor tags. And enjoy yourself a free Twilight Saga, bitch.
I'm taking it. Because you're feeling alone.
This is pretty much gonna sum up all of the pharmacy stores. Most don't actively watch their cameras. From what I've heard, all of them have loss protection that all work regionally, 8-hour shifts, usually 2 people, but this is normally only when there's a large theft, so. Now Walgreens has the big mirrors, so you need to stay out of sight of those big mirrors. CVS and Rite Aid don't have the mirror, so you're fine there. Loss protection will pretty much probably only try to get your license plate, so still be careful of other people that may look like normal people. Alright, so concealment. Probably pretty easy. Put it, jacket, you know how it is. I also made a video about what to do with a phone if you want to take small items, so. Now keep in mind that all of these places can prosecute after you've been caught, so be careful. And safe borrowing.
Oh, I'm orange, okay. Whew.
Hello, it was his 50th birthday.
But I watch her eyes as she walks by. What a sight for sore eyes, brighter than a blue sky. She's got you mesmerized while I die. Why would you ever kiss me?
5, 6, 7, 8. Dance with me in my backyard.
Watch their cameras very often. Their cameras can't zoom and or pan, so your best blind spots are right underneath the camera and on direct aisles. The best time to borrow is in the morning, there's less people. They tag, so you need to take off all peely stickers. Any other stickers that are just on the packaging that can't come off are fine. There's some metal stickers with little red dots that you should be wary of, but other than that, you're fine. They can't chase you. They also cannot confront you if they see you put something in your bag. But if you're seen on camera, they will file a report. Mainly their bathrooms are near framework, so you should probably not take something in the bathroom unless it's concealed.
Better!
Five, six, seven, eight. Dance with me in my bed.